Hello, Internet. I am Torma Ximnus, and as stated in my most recent channel update videos, I am getting into RWBY. Squee! Now, full disclosure, I have no idea what the dip I'm doing. I'm hoping that the setup that I'm putting together here will actually work, because if it doesn't, I'm going to have to do this all over again. There's probably just going to be a lot of post-production work. I'm hoping not too much. I still haven't figured out how to set things up with Open Broadcasting Software or Elgato to do the picture-in-picture thing, where I've got the smaller picture here and this is the larger picture. So, yeah. But I have a workaround. If I record with the Elgato, which, if you know that El and Gato in Spanish are the and cat, it just sounds like you're saying the cat. Actually, I think Gato might be Japanese for cat. I don't know. I'm sorry. I'm way too easily distractible sometimes. More than sometimes. Hush you. But anyway, so I am going to record myself with the Elgato, the cat, and I am going to record the RWBY stuff on OBS, which will allow me to take two separate things in the post-production software that I am using and hopefully line it up the way I want to without too much trouble. If that works, then I'll just keep doing that, at least for these first several. And then once the week of RWBY is concluded, I will look into getting a more solid setup taken care of. But for now, to get these episodes out to you guys, I'm going to just do what I can with what I have. So let's see here. And now we are going to start recording RWBY Season 5, Volume 1 in 3, 2, 1, now.
Recording, I should have said view. Mistral.
It's about time.
Yeah, seriously. It only took an entire season to get here.
Whose idea was it to walk again?
Well, whose idea was it to use the dank tunnels? That's what I want to know.
Broken airships, destroyed settlements.
Oh, and, you know, all those people and monsters that tried to murder us.
Hashtag blame Qrow.
We were fine. Only one of us almost died.
Hey.
Hey.
Hashtag blame Qrow.
So how much farther to Haven Academy?
Almost there. I'd have figured I'd take you kids on the scenic route.
Really? Scenic, huh? I don't know, the Stone Quarter gives me a more Dark Souls-y feel than anything else. Too much time in the Undead Burg, you see. And welcome to Anor Londo, City of... Oh. Oh no. No, that's actually Mistral. Okay, cool!
That's certainly something.
Wow, look at all those people.
Vendors here will sell just about anything, whether they should or not.
This has a much more of a comic book feel to it. I love the design. Oh my gosh, yes.
The higher up you go, the nicer it gets.
I could see RWBY actually being drawn as a comic and sold in comic form. If I had the money, I'd probably get that just to be able to read it.
So, how much farther?
I don't know.
We're in the home stretch now. No more stops from here to Mistral.
Hey, there's Weiss!
For the long trip. Keeping us off the radar's been harder than I thought. Lots of air traffic around Northern Anima.
It's fine. I just hope I haven't been a burden.
Oh, wow.
You and your money are more than welcome on this ship, kid.
Her hoping she hasn't been a burden. Very different from the first season or two.
Is everything okay?
I don't know. I'm still over Lake Monsu. Shouldn't be picking up broadcasts this far from Mr.
Can you hear me? Hello?
Someone must be close.
You're not supposed to be out here. He's responded.
We have a small passenger flight and our Huntress is down. We aren't equipped to deal with this.
Oh, man.
The Grim hit us 400 clicks north of the southern shoreline. Get him off us!
That's not good.
We're going to help them, right?
What? No. I'm trying to avoid them.
Excuse you?
They'll die.
Look, if we picked up their transmission, I'm sure someone else did too. Besides, this is a cargo ship. She's not much good in a fight.
And you have a Huntress on board.
Finish this job.
And it's a Schnee. She actually knows how to summon things.
My ship, my rules.
Dumb. That is dumb. Pragmatic, and I can understand his logic, but dumb. Those people needed help. Ah. Finally, Haven Academy. Whew. Oh, gotta love that old style feel. Man. Everything looks so nice and comfortable. It's just that is great. That is the kind of place where you can actually feel relaxed and the surroundings and everything just
Hello?
So good.
Hello?
Oh my gosh, the hallways are so nice.
Louder?
Yeah, I don't think they heard here. You on the other side of Mistral.
Well, I guess school isn't really in session right now. Maybe that's it.
No, this isn't right. Come on.
Wait for us!
Okay. This is going to be funny. Battle ready.
There could be trouble.
What? Oh, my courage! Oh, my health.
Qrow! For crying out loud, you nearly scared me half to death!
And my courage isn't there anymore.
Why weren't you waiting for us at the entrance?
Huh?
Oh, right.
I was late.
I guess time slipped away.
Slipped away, really.
Where is everybody?
Ah, you must be the students Qrow mentioned.
Yep.
Yes, sir. RWBY Rose.
Jean Arc.
Nor Valkyrie.
Lyren.
Mm-hmm.
Pleasure to meet you all. Leonardo Lionheart at your service.
Hello?
I'm afraid most of my staff is currently away until classes resume, but...
What? Leo, you can't be serious. Who's guarding the relic?
Qrow, children.
Already know. I filled them in. What do you mean your staff is away?
You filled them in?
You sound so surprised.
So, is this not going at all like anyone thought it would?
What did you expect? I do like how the hair actually moves now. That's something they didn't have in the first three seasons, and I don't know if they...
Unbelievable!
Total garbage! We can't let them get away with this!
Well, at least you two can finally agree on something.
Yeah, they actually are agreeing for a change!
Guys, everything's gonna be okay.
I hope so, because yeah.
Good evening, miss. Can I get you anything?
Just a little time to myself, if that's all right.
Little time to yourself. Sure. Something
thing.
Tells me
just
that's not going to go so well. And let's see here.
You need better security.
Yep, Ilya.
Please, I just need to talk.
She wants to talk.
How could you take the fall for them, Ilya? Like, Korsak and Finnick blamed you. We confronted them tonight and they denied knowing anything, and everything we found on your scroll, they talked about how disappointed they were to hear that you'd sided with Adam. But you and I both know they're guilty.
You can't prove anything. That scroll might not have been enough to lock them up, but it's enough to sway the faunas here. When we go public tomorrow, they're not going to stand for any of it.
I mean, most people wouldn't. You.
Your plan isn't going to work, Blake.
How do you know?
Please. Just leave Menagerie before it's too late.
You expect her to leave without a fight? Seriously.
You're going to have to make me.
Really? Something tells me that you were kind of hoping for something that wasn't going to happen. And now she's just angry.
I have to say, Qrow, this all seems very reckless, even for you.
No.
Now listen here, you little shit.
Leaving one of the relics completely unguarded. It's not checking in with Oz for ages.
I'm going to have a little shit counter running, like, right here. Beacon.
But since that day, Mistral has been in chaos. Vale wasn't the only kingdom to suffer that night. Everyone was watching. Every house in every kingdom saw that poor girl ripped to pieces. Saw monsters crawling over the city. Elysian knights attacking citizens. And then nothing. You could feel the dread in the air.
Oh, yeah.
With all that negativity, you can imagine what it was like when the Grimm came for us. Mistral's controlled territory is the widest reaching in the world, you know, and that makes it infinitely harder to protect.
I can imagine.
We lost so many great huntsmen, teachers from this very institution, and it's only gotten worse.
What do you mean?
We may have dealt with the Grimm, but the Mistral Council's still at odds with representatives from Atlas. First, it was the dust embargo.
Yep,
now it's
dust
the closing
embargo,
of borders.
Closing
I'm not
borders.
Sure what happened to James in Vale, but it seems to have only worsened some of his
He's got good intentions, but something tells me that Ironwood got kind of stupid. I mean, seriously.
On top of everything, we still don't know where the Spring Maiden is.
All the more reason we need the Huntsman and Huntresses here.
Okay! Things are bad. They're bad.
Look at all those
but
books
we can
just
figure this
friggin'
out.
Sitting in the top area so completely important. Unorganized. Higgly piggly everywhere.
Them in.
Mostly filled in. Look, there's a lot to cover, okay? I quit teaching for a reason.
Hashtag blame Qrow.
The four maidens each have the power to perform feats of magic.
Yep, we know that.
They are the only ones capable of reaching the relics.
And that is something that I had suspected for a while.
Inside a chamber that can only be opened by a specific maiden.
See, I had thought that it was something with only specific ones could. I had this idea that each maiden could only draw the power of their specific relic.
She was determined at first
this
when
is
she inherited her powers.
Different.
But the weight of responsibility proved to be too much for the child.
Oh yeah, that's a lot of people. A lot
she
of people.
Ran. Abandoned her training. Everyone.
Yeah.
That was over a decade ago.
Oh,
there's
damn.
No telling where she could be now.
I know.
You do.
At least, I have a pretty good idea.
Are you serious?
It's not exactly good news.
What are you talking about? This is incredible news! After all these years, where?
You gonna spill the beans, Qrow?
I did some digging around. Looks like after Spring ran away, she was picked up by bandits. Specifically, the Brownwind tribe.
Raven.
Yep.
Yang's mom?
Yep.
That's right. That's about where they've set up their main camp. It's where they fall back to after raids and scouting missions. Raven's managed to gain a lot of followers since she returned to the tribe. And I'm sure when the Spring Maiden showed up, it only made things easier.
I imagine so.
Well, Qrow, I've got to hand it to you. With these coordinates, we can mount a retrieval force and head out in a few weeks.
A few weeks, huh?
A few weeks?
Not what he was hoping for.
That's right.
Leo, maybe you didn't hear me. My sister has the Spring Maiden, and I know where she is. We need to go as soon as possible.
That's another one for the little shit counter.
And perhaps you didn't hear
Now
me.
Listen here, you little
This kingdom
shit.
Is in shambles. As soon as possible does not mean tomorrow. It means as soon as I can convince the rest of the council that I need huntsmen more than they do. Unfortunately, bandit tribes aren't very high on their list of priorities when the threat of war is just on the horizon.
Then damn the council. He's we'll do wrong. It ourselves. You and I are trained huntsmen, and these kids aren't exactly pushovers.
Yeah!
Perhaps there's a more peaceful way to approach this?
Maybe.
We need to get Spring as far away from here as possible, but Raven isn't going to give up her most prized possession without a fight.
Unfortunately, you and your sister are evenly matched, and I'm not the fighter I used to be. No offense, but these students and I can't take on an entire bandit tribe and a maiden that's no doubt had years to hone her skills.
Okay, quick pause while I deal with something.
Okay, sorry about that. I had to take care of putting the recording sign up. People got home. I forgot to make sure that I have it in place because I haven't done any recording in a while, and Anyway, continuing in 3, 2, 1, now.
We need to be positive we can apprehend Spring, because if we fail, Raven and her tribe will scatter, and we'll be lost. We get one shot at
I wonder
this.
How many...
And it needs to be perfect.
I wonder how many this is for the little shit counter. Now listen here, you little shit.
You know, Oz wouldn't be happy with any of this if he were here.
Oh.
Perhaps you're right.
I can imagine.
But he's not. I'm doing the very best I can.
There has I'm to be sure something you are. We can do.
What about Cinder? She came with Emerald and Mercury from Haven. Do you have anything on them?
We pulled their files after the fall of Beacon. Nothing but lies and forgeries.
Of course!
Well, I can't say this has been a warm reunion, Leo.
Anything but.
I'm sorry. I know you've all traveled a long way, but I will do everything I can to help.
Sure.
I'm sure you will.
Stay in the city for the time being.
Considering
local comms are still up. Keep in touch.
You know,
come on, kids.
Wasn't Lionheart speaking with someone at the end of the previous volume?
It was nice meeting you, Professor.
Or was that volume 3? At the end of one of the previous volumes, he was talking with someone who said that Salem said that Leo was always hospitable. I wonder who that could be.
Leo, we have got to work on your improvisational skills.
Like I was saying. Good grief. Oh, Qrow is not happy. Qrow's going to go from uncle
what do we do
to
now?
Drunkle.
You four head back to the house. I need a drink.
You always need a drink, Qrow. Oh, this is the bar where we saw him meeting Oscar at the end of volume 4. Or is it volume 3? Volume 4. End of volume 4. Yes!
You know, I don't think they allow kids in here, Pipsqueak.
Shut up, I'm getting there.
He's getting to it, he's getting to it.
I'm supposed to tell you. I'd like my cane back.
This guy who's totally not an Ozzy Osbourne looking mother scratcher.
It's good to see you again, Oz.
Nice. Ooh. Where's this?
Aren't you a little young to be drinking?
Ah, it's Yang!
A water. It's hot out.
It is, isn't it?
Sure.
Are you telling me you're too young to drink? You look like a regular huntress. And a beauty at that.
And here we go.
Thanks, pal.
Seriously. Not too bulky. Not too lean.
And here's the whole Goldilocks routine. Yep. Of course.
Like I said, I'm good.
And your hair.
Don't touch the hair. Get dunked on, hud. Ping pong! Not ping pong, pinball! Pinballing all over the place! That was awesome! Oh, man.
This one's on the house. He's been driving me crazy.
Nice. Easy, girl. No need for your PTSD tacked up here.
So, what brings you around these parts?
I like the fingerless gloves.
Thanks.
The open finger gloves?
I'm looking for someone.
Isn't she always?
Not many people come out here, too far from the kingdoms. Only person worth noting around here is, well, Raven.
Raven Bronwyn.
Yep.
Thanks again.
And now, Missy, here we go.
You don't want to go messing with bandits. They're a world of trouble.
She's a world of trouble.
Hey, girly.
Girly?
Seriously? This isn't
Who are you calling girly?
I heard you're looking for someone.
He looked like trouble, so yeah, he'd probably know a thing or two. Or know someone who knows someone who knows someone who knows a thing or two. Someone's at the door, are you gonna get it? Come on. Open the door, open the door! Party time! Ah. Hello, Oscar.
Can I help you? Yeah, is there a Ruby Rose here?
Aha! Wants to speak to her immediately, huh? And suddenly everyone is on guard.
I found him!
Drunkle Qrow is back!
I think that uncle could use some help.
Ooh.
Found him.
Hashtag damn it, Qrow.
Can't a girl read her comics in peace?
Apparently not.
Qrow, did you get drunk again?
It's like she's not even surprised. He did say he was going for a drink, though.
Have silver eyes.
And that was the first thing Ozpin said to her.
Who are you?
Well, my name is Oscar Pine.
Wait for it.
You probably
he says, wait for it.
Professor Ozpin?
Professor Ozpin, yep. An old man and a young boy's soul? Technically two souls. Ooh, yes! This music! Back to the fairy tale, back to the show, back to the wall, and there's nowhere to go. They're about to get worse. Yes! At first, I wasn't sure about this opening music because it's like, it didn't really hit me in the same way as some of the previous opening themes for the prior seasons. But the more I've heard it, it's like, the more awesome it sounds. It's one of those things that is a slow burn. You don't really pay it much mind at first, but then it slowly turns into liquid awesome. But let's just enjoy the rest of it, shall we? And suddenly Salem is a giant! I'm sure that's just thematic what's-its. But yeah, that has been RWBY Season 5, Episode 1. Yes! And it's only going to get better from here, I'm sure of it. Of course, I've seen up to Episode 5, so I can't really act too surprised, but I still enjoy seeing these every time. Matter of fact, what I'm probably going to do is I'm probably going to start doing reactions for these first, and then I can watch it just on my own once I've finished with the recording. Every time I've watched an episode of RWBY, I have always enjoyed letting myself get immersed in the world that the creators have made, and it's this comfortable feeling of joy. Even with some of the tenser stuff, it's like not as light, but it is still pretty awesome. And yeah, and this camera keeps constantly adjusting and readjusting and readjusting. I'm going to have to replace this. Matter of fact, I am going to replace it from here on. I'm going to be using a different one if I still have it. Really hoping I do, because if I don't, that's going to be frustrating. Well, anywho. But yeah. So, we got to see the characters again. Finally. And Uncle Qrow became Drunkle Qrow and found Ozcar, even though Ozcar was actually the one that found him. Clearly, Ozpin knew where Qrow was likely to end up. I wonder if that was just Qrow drowning his sorrows, or if that was an agreed-upon meeting spot for Qrow and Ozpin to meet again, like, at that spot, around that time. I know that Ozpin's crafty guy, and that he likely would have had contingencies in place, and since Crow's in his inner circle, and seems to be, like, one of his main guys outside of the other heads of the other academies, I'm pretty sure that Qrow would have been clued in on something with some of the contingency plans so that he would have an idea of what he would need to do. But I don't know if that means it was something that they'd had a chance to cover recently enough for it to be fresh in his mind. But of course, he is a hunter, so I don't know. Anywho, this is running a bit long at 30 minutes and some change now, so I'm going to leave it here for now. My folks will want me to help out with some stuff anyway. But, yeah, if you enjoyed watching, please be sure to like and leave a comment, subscribe for more, and ring the bell to join the notification squad so that you'll know whenever I upload something new. And until next time, this is Torma Ximnus, signing off. Stay frosty, my friends.